Hello, in this video, we will see why cholinesterase reactivator pralidoxime is indicated in organophosphate poisoning but contraindicated in carbamate poisoning. To understand this, first we will see relevant physiology of synaptic transmission. Then we will see what happens in organophosphate poisoning and how pralidoxime provides benefit in it. Then we will see carbamate poisoning and what happens if you give pralidoxime to such a patient. Let's get started. First, some physiology of transmission. This is synapse. This is nerve ending. And this is effector cell. This is acetylcholine secreted in the cleft. It acts on the postsynaptic membrane and produces various effects. These are cholinesterase enzymes. This is its catalytic site. It has an esterotic site and an anionic site. In the process of degradation, acetylcholine molecule occupies both these sites. It's cut down and degradation products are released. Then another acetylcholine molecule can bind and get degraded in the same manner. This degradation of acetylcholine by all these enzyme molecules keeps the concentration of acetylcholine in synaptic cleft in balance. This prevents the overactivation of the synaptic membrane. So this is what happens physiologically. Now let's see what happens in organophosphate poisoning. Organophosphates occupy the esterotic site of the enzyme. So acetylcholine can no longer bind here and these enzymes become useless. At present, we have only this many active enzymes. Due to reduced number of active enzymes, degradation of acetylcholine is decreased. So its concentration in cleft increases. So there will be overactivation of receptors on the postsynaptic membranes, which produces signs and symptoms of poisoning. Treatment of this is pralidoxime. See, in case of organophosphate poisoning, the anionic site is free. Pralidoxime first binds with this anionic site. This allows it to bind with organophosphate. Then the entire complex dissociates, leaving behind free enzyme. Because of this reactivation, we again have more active enzymes. These enzymes now degrade excess acetylcholine and release the symptoms of poisoning. In a nutshell, pralidoxime is useful in organophosphate poisoning. Now let's see the scenario with carbamate poisoning. Here come the carbamates. They occupy both the sites of the enzyme. So here also, acetylcholine will not get degraded, their concentration will increase and cause poisoning. See, at present, these many enzymes are inactive, but we still have these many enzymes which are active. Now let's say you give pralidoxime to this patient. To bind to carbamate, it first needs to bind to anionic site. But the anionic site is not free. It's already occupied by carbamate. So pralidoxime cannot bind to the carbamate. So it cannot reactivate the inactive enzyme. Now this jobless pralidoxime starts causing a problem. See, the anionic site is free in these active enzymes. So pralidoxime binds with them and prevents their activity. Thus pralidoxime has its own weak anticholinesterase activity. Now look at the final picture. In addition to enzymes blocked by carbamates, pralidoxime has blocked additional enzymes. This results in even more accumulation of acetylcholine and worsening of the situation. That's why pralidoxime is contraindicated in carbamate poisoning. At this point you might ask, shouldn't the anticholinesterase activity be a problem in organophosphate poisoning also? Well yes, pralidoxime shows anticholinesterase activity in organophosphate poisoning also. But the inhibition by pralidoxime is weak as compared to strong irreversible inhibition by organophosphate. So loss due to this weak anticholinesterase activity is insignificant as compared to benefit that we get in form of reactivation of blocked enzymes. Therefore, they are useful in carbamate poisoning. So that was all the detail. As a summary, let's make an account of benefit and loss with pralidoxime in case of organophosphate and carbamate poisoning. For pralidoxime to work, the anionic site of enzyme must be free. In organophosphate poisoning, it is free. So pralidoxime can bind to this site and then take away the organophosphate molecule. So the benefit of reactivation of enzyme is present in organophosphate poisoning. But in case of carbamate poisoning, anionic site is occupied and pralidoxime cannot work on such enzymes. So there is no reactivation of carbamylated enzyme. Small loss due to weak anticholinesterase activity is present in both the cases. The final answer is, pralidoxime is indicated in organophosphate poisoning because the benefit is much more than the loss. But it's contraindicated in carbamate poisoning because there is no benefit as there is no reactivation of enzyme. There is only loss. So they are contraindicated. I hope this clears all your confusions regarding why pralidoxime is contraindicated in carbamate poisoning. That's it for this video. If you found this video helpful, please share it with your friends and colleagues too. And don't forget to subscribe Nonstop Neuron, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.